meeting down at Westchester, she was also recognized, so. And you were installed here in February of 2015.
She is here 7 years, so we're not blessed to have you. Everybody, look, I got.
Thank you, I appreciate it. And we're going to bless these candlesticks. These are also dedicated by the Memorial Fund, okay? But the candles are a memory of Rich.
No.
The candles are in the candlesticks.
It's the candles.
The candles themselves.
Oh, your mother. I'm sorry, I thought it was memory of Rich. No, but the candelabras and the candles here were memory of Rich.
You just want to say a prayer. Okay. And we pray, amen. Oh, you gotta talk about Juneteenth now. Well, what do we have to say?
This is me. I'm sorry, this is Susan again. In your bulletin, it's Blessed Juneteenth. Again, people don't realize 1776 was the independence of our country. However, the Emancipation Proclamation was signed by Abraham Lincoln in 1865, setting all the colored folks. However, at the end of the Civil War, it was 2 years later, in 1865, that the slaves were freed in Galveston, Texas. So when you realize how fast we all travel, and we all get on a plane and go everywhere, back then it was 2 years until all of the colored people were set free. And again, I think it's very interesting, I said, please put this in the bulletin. So we have multiple celebrations today. Enjoy the bulletin, they're beautiful.
Right. Yeah, so that it took 2 years because of the troops had to come in. As a deer gets thirsty for
Of the Lord is from
everlasting to everlasting. Through Jesus Christ, we are forgiven. Amen.
You know what day today?
Father's Day.
Father's Day.
You have a favorite father here today?
Yes.
Good. I'm glad that you do. So what's great about that?
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Did you ever catch any fish?
Uh-huh. That's great. So, and
do you ever, does your dad ever, when I was a kid, all right, and what do dads do that only they can do? Well, I can think of one is that they can shave their face. Do you ever shave your face?
No, no.
But we'll practice being a dad, okay? So, if this is a razor, but...
Thank you. No? Okay. Company of the prophets of Jericho went up to Elisha and asked him, "Do you know that the Lord is going to take your master from you today?" "Yes, I know," he replied. "So be quiet." Then Elijah said to him, "Stay here, the Lord has sent me to the Jordan." And he replied, "As surely as the Lord lives and as you live, I will not leave you." So the two of them walked on. 50 men from the company of the prophets went and stood at the distance, facing the place where Elijah and Elisha had stopped at the Jordan. Elijah took his cloak, rolled it up, and struck the water with it, and the water divided to the right and to the left, and the two of them crossed over on dry ground. When they had crossed, Elijah said to Elisha, "Tell me, what can I do for you before I am taken from you? Let me inherit a double portion of your spirit," Elisha replied. "You have asked a difficult thing," Elijah said. "Yet if you see me when I am taken from you, it will be yours. Otherwise, it will not." As they were walking along and talking together, suddenly a chariot of fire and horses of fire appeared and separated the two of them. And Elijah went up to heaven in a whirlwind. Elisha saw this and cried out, my father, the chariots and the horsemen of Israel." And Elisha saw him move no more. Then he took hold of his garment and tore it in two. Elisha then picked up Elijah's cloak that had fallen from him and went back and stood on the bank of the Jordan. He took the cloak that had fallen from Elijah and struck the water with it. "Where now is the Lord, the God of Elijah?" he asked. When he struck the water, it divided to the right and to the left, and he crossed over. Our second reading is from James chapter 2, verses 20-24. "You foolish person,
you want evidence that faith without deeds is useless? Not our father Abraham considered righteous for what he did, and when he offered his son Isaac on the altar? You see that his faith and his actions were working together, and his faith was made complete by what he did. And the scripture was fulfilled that says, 'Abraham believed God, and it was credited to him as righteousness, and he was called God's friend.' see that a person is considered righteous by what they do and not by faith alone. Our gospel reading is in your bulletin. It's from John 15, verses 9 through 17. As the Father has loved me, so have I loved you. Now remain in my love. If you keep my commands, you will remain in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commands and remain in his love. I have told you this so that my joy may be with you and that your joy may be complete. My command is this: love each other as I have loved you. Greater love has no other than this: to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command. I no longer call you servants, because servants does not know his master's business. Instead, I have called you friends, for everything that I have learned from my Father, I have made known to you. You did not choose me, but I choose you, and appointed you so that you might go and bear fruit, fruit that will last. And so that whatever you ask in my name, the Father will give you. This is my command: love each other. This is the good news.
Praise to you.
Well, dad is actually really important.
and the dad is active
in your kid's life, it makes a huge difference
in helping
a child develop good self-esteem and do well in school and life. Plus, dad can make a big impact on the kid's spiritual life. A dad who's active in their faith helps their kids get closer to God. And a really important thing that God does for his kid is to be
a friend. And today we're going to hear about
people in the Bible that are God's friends and Jesus' friends.
And you'll learn that God
is your friend and how important it is
that you are
a friend to others.
And sometimes it's
a little controversial if you say that a parent can be a
friend of their child.
Because there's this idea that the child needs you to be
your parent and not so sometimes being
a parent means your kid does not like you and you need
to be the parent. But the thing is that
kids go through difficult times when life gets more complicated.
And I think about
middle school for me being a difficult time growing up. And you know, you have a friend who stops talking to you, or you try to be accepted by your peers, and you get teased, or
you know, times like those the most.
Proverbs 18:24 says, "One who has unreliable friends soon comes to ruin."
But there is a friend who
sticks closer than a brother. A friend who sticks closer than a brother, that sounds like a dad to me. And you know, even if you don't have a father growing up, you probably find a way to have people fill that role in your life. Find a coach or a teacher or a friend to be that father figure and friend who helps you find your way, and a friend who is there whenever
you need them. And James 2:23 says, "Abraham
believed God, and it was credited to him as righteousness, and he was called God's friend."
So, God is a friend. But, you know, God
was Abraham's God. And God told him, "Leave your homeland. Go where I will tell you." And Abraham obeyed, although he didn't always do the right thing. Like when he told his wife that he was afraid when they go to Egypt that the Egyptians will want to kill him because Sarah's beautiful and want to marry her. So he told Sarah, "Just tell everybody that you're my sister."
And you have to wonder, you know,
what was he thinking? He wasn't thinking. Abraham was not perfect. He was not on God's level. But he tried to follow God, to obey. And God considered Abraham a friend. And then in today's gospel reading, John 15:14-15,
Jesus says, "You are my friends. So Jesus is friends
with his disciples. So he's been their mentor. He's been with them all the time. They know what he's about. Because of Jesus, they know God.
So Jesus is friends with his disciples.
God is friends with Abraham. And that means if you're on the path, you're following God, and you too are a friend of God. He's God, but he thinks the world of you.
He's close, he's available to you,
and he has your best interests at heart. So God is a friend who sticks closer than a brother. And God models for us what it is to be a parent. If God can be friends with us humans, that means that parents can be friends with their kids.
And when you're a parent
who is
than your kid and have boundaries
because your kids
respect you enough
to obey you.
So when life is difficult, kids
need not just any friend, they need
a parent who is closer to them
than their friends. They need a parent who has more life experience and wisdom than a peer.
So parents.
Friend.
You could take that moment
to let your anger die down and find that you can like your kid. You
know, they don't really mean what they say. They don't want you
to hate them. At that moment, they really need you to hang in there and still believe in them. So that might not be in the nursery or even parenting book or in the school to find out if their kid needs to go to the doctor. But that's
as seeking out your kid and playing a game with them,
or telling them what is great about them. And I think everybody loves to be told something like, you're so good at baking, I love your chocolate chip cookies. Or I like you because you are a good listener.
Or you are so creative. When someone tells me
what they like about me, like specifically, you know, I could listen to that all day. I bet you could listen to that all day too. That, you know, usually in confirmation class, once we'll make these affirmation posters where everybody puts a name on the middle of their poster, and then everybody writes around their name what they like about that person. And that's a keeper. I always keep mine, you know.
So we're pretty good at that.
We're good at telling each other, you're great. So that's the homework this week, is to tell a young person, or not so good person, tell someone you're great at whatever. Tell them what you like about them. So you are a friend of God. He's God, but he's wild about you. And is the creator of heaven and earth. And Jesus,
our Redeemer. So dads are really
great and very important to the well-being of your children. It can be hard to raise kids.
It's a sacrifice
to forgive and always look for the greatness in your child. But this sacrifice has a reward that's out of this world. You know, when you like your kids and when you are their friends,
in good times and bad,
they learn to trust you
and they feel affirmed. So
one who has unreliable friends soon comes to ruin, but there is a friend who sticks closer
than a brother.
So happy Father's Day. Amen.
Oh, holy God, we give you our praise and thanks. We give you glory. We are grateful that we can gather here now in your presence. Thank you that when we follow you, you are our God and our friend. And we know that there are people out there who need a friend. They need someone to love them unconditionally, to see their greatness, to reassure them and believe. And help us to know that the sacrifice of being a friend actually turns out to be a gift. A gift of joy as we receive as we pour into a young person and help them find their way in life. We pray for dads. We wouldn't be here without them, and we pray that they will be encouraged on this Father's Day. We ask your presence in our world. And we pray for everyone affected by the strain of inflation. We pray for healing for the sick, and we pray for those who have lost loved ones, especially the family and friends of David Lang. We're grateful for the miracles that you work, O God, for the strength you give us from home and family and friends, for work and relaxation. We lift up to you now our prayer request and our thanks for all that you bless us with. Jesus' name, we ask, amen. Let us pray the prayer our Savior taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Thy is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever.
And now go forth in the love of
God, the peace of Christ, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you.